Hey guys, Hardware Hound here. So I picked up a video today. Jay's Two Cents, he had a video out today talking about how he makes money on his channel. And it came from a tweet that was basically saying, hey, these YouTube guys, they're charging vendors, basically, manufacturers, that if they're going to go to their booth and cover stuff, then they have to pay to get that coverage. And so Jay was explaining how, hey, this doesn't happen and stuff. And I just, you know, guys, I don't really defend myself a lot because I don't want to feed the trolls and stuff, you know, and I just feel like there's not a lot of need to. But I do kind of feel like I want to defend other people sometimes. And, you know, some of these guys, I aspire to want to be kind of like them. I mean, I don't want to be exactly like them because I don't want to be Jay. I don't want to be Linus. I don't want to be, you know, Paul, or I forget who the guy's name is at Bitwit. But, you know, I don't want to be those guys because I feel like if all I wanted to do was be those guys, then why put a channel up? Just let them do the work. But I do want to aspire to follow their examples. So particularly with Jay's Two Cents, you know, I really like Jay when I've watched his videos. I like the way he handles his channel, so I subscribe to him, and I always keep a track because I feel like he's a good inspiration to a guy like me. You know, I don't always know what I'm doing. I'm still figuring it out. You know, he talked about his expenses. I mean, if I could make a quarter of what he makes in a year, I could, you know, in a year of what he has to spend in a month, I could do so much more. Like, I could buy so much more equipment, do a lot more ideas, I could take more time off work. I mean, so, yeah, obviously I'm nowhere near to level of him, but what I love about him is the integrity factor and the way that he cares about his viewers and the fact that his content is so spot on. And so I want to just, you know, if you catch that video, in fact, I'll link that in the description below so you guys can check it out, but I just want to tell you, everything he's saying is just spot on. He's 100% right about that. There is no way. I've been to CES a few times. I've actually been in the Corsair booth. It was either, you know, 1 or 2 years ago. I was in the Corsair booth while he was there. And he's sitting here talking to Corsair's reps, and he's talking about their hardware. And you can tell, this guy loves what he does. He's not, I can guarantee you, like, I guess I don't know 100% for sure, but if I was to take every instinct that I've got in the matter, I'd guarantee you he's not charging him any money. Because the kind of relationship he's built is one that looks out of mutual respect. He respects them for trying to bring amazing hardware designs to the market, and they respect him for giving them fair, good coverage reviews of their products. He's not just trying to say good things about their product because he's hoping he can get more stuff. That's not his purpose in life. And, you know, I feel like I'm in the same boat in that sense. You know, I'm a very positive, very enthusiastic guy. So I'm going to say a lot of good things about this stuff that a lot of other people may nitpick more. It's not because I'm trying to get more free stuff. It's just because I love it. I love getting my hands on stuff. I've got a different take, and that's, you know, to the point that I don't want to be Jay, and I don't want to be Linus or these other guys, because I'm wanting to be more of a positive, upbeat. That's just my personality. I don't want to be super harsh and critical. So I never will be. So when Jay is saying that stuff, I mean, I'd say he's 100% right. 100%. And I don't know why anybody would even throw that out there. I get that we'll jump on, that sometimes you can jump on things, but like, it would be pretty easy to just do a verification and say, hey, do you do this? No? Oh, okay. And, you know, if that tweet gets redacted, or if the person who spread that info says, hey, we got it wrong, I'm okay with that too, guys. I'm gonna be honest. Everybody makes mistakes. And I don't want to hold a mistake to somebody if they are honestly just trying to get news coverage and thought they found something and they just made a jump too soon. Not a big deal. But if they won't redact that kind of information when it's pretty clearly bad, then that's just wrong. And I hope that's not the case. I hope that information isn't being held to by the people that are spreading it as if it's some kind of truth. I'm there, guys. I mean, even CES, I mean, just crossing paths with Linus while I'm walking around to my own booths and stuff. You know, those guys are doing way more than I am. they're not forcing vendors to pay for that. I'd guarantee it. And I feel like that was kind of a shameful thing to do. YouTube is a crap ton of work. And I'm not putting the levels that these guys are. And now some of that's because they have more resources than me too, and so I get that. But YouTube is not, you don't do this stuff because you're just wanting to make it big. And I feel like the people who are, they're probably not getting very far. You usually do this because there's something you really love and you're just wanting to put yourself out there and share it. And that's kind of how it works. You know, guys, even me though, and I'll throw this mention out here. I've had people say, well, I must be getting paid or that. I get free samples from certain companies, and that's it. I don't get paid reviews. Nobody is coming to a guy with 1,900 subscribers. Really? Somebody's going to come to a guy with 1,900 subscribers and go, hey, we'll pay you this much money if you'll do this review. No. Uh-uh. They'll just send me product, and that's it. And that's kind of the normal thing. But see, it's not just for my YouTube channel. People who are sending me things are also sending me for the website that I write for, which was Pure Overclock, because it had enough of a presence in the industry that allows me to have a little more traction to help build this YouTube channel. But I have to do both, guys. I have to do video, and then I have to do a full written 5 to 7 page type review style on that website. You don't do this for the big bucks that you get. It's not how it works. So yeah, and in fact, I really, really appreciate Jay just being 100% honest about how he does it, because you know why? Not only is he being real and upfront with his viewers, but he's giving guys like me ideas of, oh, so that's how he does it. I should probably implement some of those ideas. Like, he gave me some amazing, great ideas to help me out on my little channel. So Jay isn't just helping his viewers, he's helping other little guys like me and being an awesome guy on the internet. I just wanted to come to his defense and say that, and I know I probably won't get a ton of views on this, but hey, for the few of you guys, I hope it counts, and I hope you guys just give these guys some credit. It's hard work to do this, and I'm doing it on a small scale, and I already am like, oh my goodness, what did I get myself into some days? But, you know, these other guys, they don't deserve any crap like that. They're doing the best they can to give stuff to you guys that they think is going to help you. You know, I say have some respect for that, personally. But hey, you know what they also say about opinions. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this. Hope it wasn't feeling too ranty. I'll catch you later.